the legend of Denver High School basketball. Check out these clips. JB here with the highest basketball socks I've ever seen. Dropped 37 points in a win over Eagle Crest. He later told me that that stat line was near triple-double. I have to fact-check that. He also won a state title in 96, was on the first team All-State and Player of the Year out of Denver East. And this is the icing on the cake as well. His nephew, Jordan Bickerstaff, is the Nuggets Video Room Associate. Here's what he tweeted earlier, a battle of the Bickerstaffs. Which one walks away with the bragging rights? We will soon find out, guys.
Thank you, Angel. JB Bickerstaff is far from the only famous person to have graduated from East High School in Denver. And he liked actor Don Cheadle, one-time NBA All-Star Joe Barry Carroll, and former First Lady Mamie Eisenhower. All East High School alums.
Very distinguished group.
Under two to go in the half. Lowry Markkanen back on the floor. He just started the Cavs with a steal and a coast-to-coast dunk. Allen, Markkanen, in toward Jokic, clears some space. Allen got a hand on it, he tips it in. Darren Allen's nice first half continues. How about 11 points and 8 boards? He's 5 of 6.
And that's tough to tip in a ball like that. Good touch by the big fella.
Gordon. Jokic. Baseline threw it away, picked off by Garland. Jokic is back behind the plate. He's frustrated. It's Garland now. Bothered by Gordon, goes baseline, deals to Love. Wide open! Pockets the corner three.
K-Love sitting in the corner, just waiting deep in the ball arena.
The body language after that steal of Jokic, he looked tired. Why? Because Allen been physical throughout this first half. There's Allen and Jokic again. Loose ball grabbed by Garland. Garland's on the run with his head up. Stutter steps by the trailer. Markkanen gets fouled.
I tell you, Garland has almost eyes the back of his head. He does a good job of understanding who's around to give the ball to. Super move by the young fella to get it to Markkanen, who's a seven-footer running the floor. Give him the ball. Exactly what he does. He goes to the line. Two shots.
Credit Jared Allen on both ends. Cavaliers basketball on Bally Sports Ohio is brought to you by your local Toyota dealer. For all Toyota offers, go to buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. Well, two nights ago in the victory over Atlanta at home, Cavaliers closed a number of quarters the right way, and that's precisely what they're doing here at the end of the second as they've opened up this 10-point lead.
Learning how to close quarters is how you win the ball game. They did a great job against the Hawks. Only one turnover in that last quarter. Super effort to close the game out.
The current Cavalier run is 11-3. Morris zigzags. Jokic fires a three. Got it. Oh, boy.
Well, you know he was going to go outside sooner or later. He wouldn't have much success from the foul line in, so he goes outside. But that's why he's an MVP.
Jokic has a first half double-double, a dozen points, 11 rebounds, but he's had to work for it. 17 minutes. He's the high nugget in that department. Garland long three. Jokic with another board. He'll chug into the forecourt once again. Garland reached it. Oh, Tony Brothers is going to call a shooting foul here. Oh, my goodness. JB Bickerstaff is fuming.
Wow.
He is fuming. The question is, were his head and shoulders moving in an upward direction before the foul?
Oh,
that's the trigger point. Where's the contact? Oh, boy. On a jump shot, yep, it's not the gather. It's on a jump shot. It's when the player's head and shoulders start to move in an upward direction. If the foul occurs before that, it is a foul on the floor. Tony Brothers ruled that Jokic's head and shoulders were moving upward before the contact was made, and JB Bickerstaff just continues to bend the ear of the veteran official. Jokic drains all three. First half comes to